Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us discuss how to use Git Secret to protect the secure data in Git repository. One of the challenges with Git repository is handling the files with secret data such as password, server details and other sensitive data that should be protected. Those files can't be versioned. If versioned, the data will be accessible by everyone having the repository access. Git Secret is a bash tool to store your private data inside a Git repository. So Git Secret encrypts files and stores them inside the Git repository. So you will be able to version all the project files including the one with the secret data. So also the data can be easily revealed by the user who has the required access. So it encrypts using GPG utility that tracked files or the secret files will be encrypted with the public keys of all the users who should be having the access. So let's say like I want to give access for 10 user, the file should be encrypted with all 10 users public key. So everyone, one of them can decrypt these files using only their personal secret key. So whoever having that corresponding secret key, they will be able to decrypt. So the new user will not be able to access the existing encrypted files. The files should be encrypted, re-encrypted, so that they can access it. If you are adding a new user and providing the access, but he will not able to access the existing files. So we need to the owner should be re-encrypting those files. So to remove the access for the user, just to remove the public key. So also again re-encrypt the data so that the user will not have the access anymore. So let us see now how to do that. So I have a public repository. So I'm enabling a secret file going to provide the access for one of the user. For that specific secret file. I will be doing this in two different machines, one for owner and another one for additional user. So let us enable the required configuration as a owner now. Perform all the owner related tasks. So before that, I want to show from where I referred this video. So this is the URL, gitsecret.io. You will get more detail. Maybe the video will give the end-to-end demo, but here every detail is already available in this particular URL. So let us go and, I'm going with the owner. So first I need to install the Git Secret. So for that, you need to execute some command. Let me show that. Okay, this one is the first one. We need to get this RPM. Let me go and install. Yeah, that's fine. Now let me copy that or move this into the etc folder, required folder. Okay, that's done. Now let me go and install. Let me accept it. Now the installation is complete. So now what we need to do is as a next step. So we need to generate a key using the GPG utility. So GPG utility will be available. Default. You need to install the GPG utility also. So let me generate that. You need to go to GPG, type GPG --gen key. Yeah, this will create a key pair. I'm going to option one. This is because you may not get this all the option in the options in different servers. This is Amazon Linux, so that's the reason some of the additional options are. I'm selecting one. My key size is fine, 148. That's fine. I'm leaving it valid forever. So I'm accepting that. Yeah, real name, maybe I will give this one as test one. Then I need to give a email address. I'm going with test1@gitsecret .com. Okay, gitsecret.com. This is fine. I'm give some command test. Okay, I'm accepting this. Yeah, need to provide some fast phrase. So keep this noted. So you need this data to access the data. Okay, Now this is completed. Now like you can encrypt the existing data, or you can go with a new repository. Anything is possible. So I am going with a new repository. So for that I'm like I need to init maybe here. Yep, I have another folder creator. Let me go inside that. Let me, I don't have any data now. I'm executing this init command here. Okay, the repository is initer. Now let me create some secret file here. So for that I'm just saying vi maybe test secure data dot txt. Okay, I'm just entering some random data. This is okay, this is secure data test data something. Okay, you can enter it and let me save it. Okay, now I have a secure file that need to be encrypted. So now what we need to do is to this repository we need to initialize the git secret. So for that you type this command git secret init. Okay, that is done. Now after this we need to add the user, because this I am a owner, I need to add my user ID, email ID. So git again git secret tell I give the user the email ID test one git dot com. This is my email ID for as a owner. I'm just clicking enter. Okay, now yeah, user also added. Now what we need to do is we need to add the file, whatever the file need to be secured, that file, all those files should be added into git secret. For that we can execute this command git secret again add. So my case I have only one file now, this test secure data. I'm just typing it. Yeah, one file is now added. So now yeah, everything setup is ready as a owner. Now we need to encrypt the file. So for that we can execute git secret hide. Yeah, this is the command to encrypt. So you can add this flag minus d. So what does that mean is this will remove the original file. So after encryption, so I want to remove that. So it's fine, like you're saying one of one files are hidden. If you go and see it, the file the secret file is created, the original file got deleted. If I just view this, you will not able to read through this because it's having the encrypted data. But as a owner, because you are in the same repository, you can, if you want, you can reveal and see it. So for that, again, you need to execute git secret reveal. Yep. So you need to enter the phrase here. Yep. Now it's saying one of one files are revealed. So if we go here, yeah, it will show you the original file. So if I go inside, yeah, it will have the original file. Okay, say owner, it's like working as suspected. Let me remove that file again. I don't want, yeah. Now this is fine. Now I need to push this changes to the repository. So that like I can add another user, so he'll be able to get the access. So let me push this code to repository, remote repository. Okay. Yeah, sorry. Type there wrong comment. Okay, now you add like maybe I need to set the email ID so that it will help for identifying who is committing. Yeah, okay, this command you can execute. This I'm just setting a user email for the git. Okay, this is done. Now as a next step, yeah, you can commit it, maybe add some comment. Okay, commit is completed. Now set this remote origin value. So what is the repository? This is my repository, remote repository. So I'm going with setting that. Now finally you execute this push command. Okay, now you need to enter the remote repository username and password. Okay, now the data is pushed to the remote repository. Let me go and check it, how it's looking. Yeah, it's done, like, but anyway, I'm only having the secure data. So I will, like, nobody, this is the public repository again. So nobody able to see this data. So right now, so what I want to do now is like I want to add a user, so that user should be having the access to reveal this secure data. So for that, what we will do is like let me go into the another machine. So yeah, this is the as a user, it's a separate machine. So here again you need to install those Git secret. So let me go and execute all those commands, initial commands. Okay, now done. This one, same thing again. Okay, install the Git secret. Okay, now Git secret is installed here. Now let me clone the repository. Let me again I create a folder here. Okay, let me go into this command. Okay, now it's cloned. Go into the repository. So now you can see the test secure data, but I will not able to read that as a user. So if I execute git secret reveal, so it say like there is no the key available, no secret key available to decrypt it. So now like again like as a user, I should be creating a key pair again, so GPG, so that public key can provide it to the owner, so he can enable the access. So GPG again gen key. Okay, I can go with the first option, then 204, right? Maybe these options will not be same in all the OS, but this is Amazon Linux, so that is the reason. So selections will be different. Okay, why? Okay, real name, I'm going and giving here test2 maybe. Then my email address is test2@gitsecret.com. Okay, this is the email ID. Okay, comment maybe test2. Okay, I'm going to accept this. Okay, enter some phrase, welcome something. Okay, that. Okay, now the key is created. Now what we need to do is we need to export the public key, so that key can provide it to the owner. So I'm going and exporting this so that you can use this comment. So I will be sharing maybe all this, some of the comment. Okay, I'm exporting this. Yeah, now exported this. If you see here, like a key.txt file is there. Now we need to send this file to the owner. So then owner should be enabling this key into the repository and push the changes to the repository and commit the changes so that we will be having the access. So now let me download this and maybe configure it in the owner machine. Okay, let me now download the key. So that's generated over here. This is the user machine. So let me download to my local host. Okay. Okay, fine. Now let me go into the owner machine. So I'm going and copying to this machine. Okay, that's fine. Now let me go into the putty again. So to the owner machine. Okay. Now let me export it. Import it. GPG import key dot. Okay, I have the key.txt now. Just execute this. Import. Okay, after the importing, you need to execute another command because you need to add the user. So you can execute this specific command. Git secret tell test2 at git secret. Okay, user is added now. So it is ready. So now also after this also we need to push this changes. But even after that, even if the user download the latest code, he will not able to decrypt the file. So what we need to do is, like, we need to re-encrypt. So that's what I was discussing earlier. So even you add the public key or enable the user, he will not able to see the old files or decrypt the old file. So for that, we need to the owner should be re-encrypting the files with this, including this public key. So now the public key is included. So now what we can do is, let us go into the repository. Yeah, this is the repository. So I'm going to, maybe I will remove the key somehow, or let's fine, leave it for now. It's anyway test. So what I will do, I need to reveal this. So for that, you need to execute git secret reveal. Okay, enter the value. Fine, it's a reveal now. Now what we can do is, maybe you can remove the this file. Okay, now again encrypt. For that, again execute git secret, okay, hide minus d. okay, yeah, it's again encrypted. So what we need to do is, now we need to push this change to the repository. So for that, again execute add git commit. Okay, and do some comment, user add. Okay, then now push this change to remote repository. Master. Okay, enter the credential. Okay, it's now push to the repository, remote repository. Now what you can do is, you can go into the user machine. So let us now pull the changes. For that, execute git pull in master. Okay, I think let us remove that file then. That's fine. Okay, git pull origin master. Okay, now the file is merged. So let us go and see. Yes, fine. Now let us try to reveal this secret. It should be revealing now. Yeah, it's asking the phrase now. That's fine. Yes, revealed. So if I go into that, so I can see the file now. Yeah, the data now. So even though this is the public repository, so like only the specified users can see this secure data. So whoever whoever's public key is enabled in the repository and the user is added, only those people can see the secure data. So remaining people only see the encrypted data, but they will not able to decrypt the data. So even the decryption step can be easily integrated to your deployment pipeline. So anything like you want automated, you will be able to do it easily. So only this reveal command should be executed. So another one is, like, if you want to remove the user access, that's very simple. So what we can do is, you can execute this delete command of the user. Yeah, delete this with the same user email. What is the user email you used while adding? Use the same email ID. With that, you can able to remove the user. But you need to ensure, like, you are re-encrypting that. Because like earlier, let's say you had a 10 public key, 10 user you added, you encrypted for all 10 public key. Now you are removing one, you need to re-encrypt, otherwise the user will continue, like, you will still have the access. So another option, maybe we thought about, we discuss about the git secret, but another one is, one option is like git crypt. So maybe you can read through this. This is another option to achieve this git secret or like encryption. Okay, thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.